top tips, pero I guess number one, be present.
Physically?
Not, well, yes, physically present when you're with your child, whether it's 1-5 minutes, you should really be there. Sometimes we're so busy with our, you know, day-to-day activities that when your child's talking to you, ah, sandali ah, may Facebook muna ako, mag-text. But when your child is talking to you, actually listen. It's easier said than done. Ang hirap to, for me, it's also a tip that I'd like to follow myself. It's also something that I tell myself every day, actually. We're thinking so much about the future, what your child will be. Will she be a superstar? Will she be a doctor? Magiging lawyer ba siya? Magiging engineero ba siya? Diba? Ang dami nating gusto para sa ating mga anak. That we forget the present. We forget that they are someone today. Na tao na sila ngayon. Pa 5 years old, kahit 3 years old lang yan. They're already very important human beings that kailangan pakinggan, alagaan at mahalin. So, I guess that's my number one tip. Don't think too much about what they will be in the future. Excuse me, in the future, what they will become. Will they be superstars or not? But what they are now, be there for them. And, you know, be there when they need you. And listen to them. And accept them for who they are. Ang hirap, kasi ako, hindi naman lahat ng bata perfect eh. Pero, yun nga eh, sinasabi, ang natutunan ko, no, ang isang ina talaga, ang pagmamahal niya sobrang lawak na ang hirap minsan magmahal ng isang batang matigas ang ulo eh. Or sumasagot, or may problema, di ba? Pero yun yung talagang dapat mong mahalin at yakapin, yung datang sometimes problematic, sometimes rebellious, pero sila yung dapat mong tutukan. Well, yun. Number two, it's okay to fail. Like I mentioned, I won't make it long. The more we fail, di ba? For some of us, it makes us better people. So yung anak mo, kahit di honor student, kahit sumali sa contest, pero last siya, or hindi mo kailangan last. Huwag naman last. kahit di siya nanalo, or what, no? Ang importante, yung journey niya papunta doon, yung paano mo siya tinulungan, or paano mo siya sinuportahan. Doon sa ginawa niya, like Catherine Bernardo, she lost a contest when she was 6. Napaka-traumatic nun eh, di ba? Pero imbis na yun ay maging traumatic sa kanya, ayaw ko na, I will never be successful, lalo pa siyang nag-strive to be better. So yun, failures are okay. Actually, allow your child to fail. Kesa sa lagi silang winner, di ba? You can't be a winner all the time. And last,
don't wish them.
That will never fail forever. Sometimes. Allow them to fail sometimes. And ako, I have the gadgets. Eh. I have a problem with that. Ang hirap tanggalin yung iPad and cell phone sa kanila. Pero sana, no, in this world that's so fast and we're all just tweeting, Instagramming, picture, di ba? At papasikatan sa Facebook na actually fake book naman yan eh. Huwag kayong papadala. Maraming nade-depress dahil, ay, mas successful sila, mas masayang pamilya nila. Ang, di ba? Parang compare ka ng compare. But, siguro, mas maganda yung live in the moment, no? And stop muna all these gadgets. Listen to your child. Go out, di ba? Be active. Sa akin, importante na yung mga anak mo active, eh. They should be into sports sana, no? Hindi ba kailangang winner sa sports or competitive sports, no? But when your child is into sports, they become disciplined. They will wake up early for a practice, di ba? They will not have a boyfriend yet kasi bawal makapagdaldalan muna or Facebook ng hanggang hating gabi kasi kailangan kong gumising na maaga. I mean, it teaches discipline and healthy. Magiging healthy ka. You will eat the right kinds of food kasi you know that the next day you have to perform, you have to run or swim or what. So yun, for me, let live an active lifestyle. Thank you.